Hello viewers, if you are new to the channel, please hit the like and subscribe button and share it with your friends. Also, click on the bell icon so that you get the latest information about the videos that are uploaded. Hello students, welcome back to the new video. In this video, we are going to start chapter number 18, Pollution of Air and Water. In today's session, we will discuss about air pollution. Introduction. Air, water and land are the three essential elements needed for life. However, due to exploding population and development activities, we have disturbed the delicate balance maintained in nature. These human activities are the major reason behind the different types of pollution. Pollution refers to the contamination of or damage to the environment by release of harmful substances. As you know, air, water and land are very essential for the life to exist. But due to the human activities, the balance between these three elements are getting disturbed nowadays. So these human activities are the major reason behind the different types of pollution. So what is pollution? Pollution refers or pollution means the contamination or damage to the environment by the release of harmful substances. Air pollution. The atmosphere is composed of a mixture of several different gases. The permanent gases whose percentages do not change from day to day are nitrogen, oxygen and argon. Nitrogen accounts for 78% of the atmosphere, oxygen 21% and argon 0.9%. So atmosphere is a mixture of several gases in which there are three gases whose percentage do not change, that is they remain constant. They are nitrogen, oxygen and argon. As you know, nitrogen constitutes 78% of the atmosphere, oxygen 21% and argon 0.9%. Gases such as carbon dioxide, nitrous oxides, methane and ozone are the trace gases which make up less than 1% of the atmosphere. Water vapor concentration varies from 0 to 4% of the atmosphere depending on time and location. So the other gases such as carbon dioxide, nitrous oxide, methane, they are called as trace gases because they make up less than 1% of the atmosphere. Similarly, water vapor concentration also varies. It varies between 0 to 4% depending on the time and location. Human activities and rapid industrialization are responsible for the release of harmful and undesirable substances into the air. The presence of unwanted particles, gases and biological molecules that makes air unfit for breathing is called air pollution. Such harmful and undesirable substances are called pollutants. So what is air pollution? Air pollution means the presence of unwanted particles, gases, biological molecules, etc. which make the air unfit for human use. And these substances are called pollutants and this process is called air pollution. Now let us see what are the common air pollutants found all over the world. First one, carbon monoxide. The greatest source of carbon monoxide is the incomplete combustion of fuels used in car, trucks and other vehicles or machinery that burn fossil fuels. Burning of wood, coal and kerosene and usage of gas space heaters and gas stoves also release carbon monoxide. So, carbon monoxide is the greatest source of pollutants, air pollutants found all over the world. And from where the carbon monoxide is released? By the incomplete combustion of fuels used in the vehicles and also in the machineries and the burning of wood, coal, kerosene, etc. release carbon monoxide. The second pollutant is lead. Sources of lead are ores and metal processing units, vehicles using leaded fuel and lead acid battery. The third pollutant is nitrogen dioxide and sulfur dioxide. Burning of fossil fuels and their emission from vehicles and power plants release sulfur dioxide and nitrogen dioxide into the air. Fourth one, ground level ozone. It is called bad ozone as it causes many health hazards. It is formed at the surface of the earth by the chemical reaction between oxides of nitrogen and volatile organic compounds. So the ground level ozone is called as bad ozone. What is the reason? Because it causes many health hazards. And this bad ozone is formed at the surface of the earth by the chemical reaction between the oxides of nitrogen and volatile, that is easily vaporizing organic compounds. The fifth pollutant is particulate matter, PM. Particulate matter, also known as particle pollution, is a complex mixture of extremely small particles of carbon and other pollutants that is suspended in the air. So, particulate matter, it is also known as particle pollution, which contains very minute or extremely small particles of carbon and other pollutants in the air. The sixth pollutant is chlorofluorocarbons, CFCs. Ozone in the stratosphere is called good ozone. It protects us from the harmful ultraviolet radiations that come from the sun. These UV rays are very bad for living beings and can cause cancer and kill life on the earth. The substance such as chlorofluorocarbons or freons used as coolants in air conditioners, refrigerators and aerosols reach the stratosphere and react with ozone to deplete it. As a result, only a thin layer of ozone is left in the stratosphere. One chlorine molecule released from CFC can deplete 1 lakh ozone molecules. So this has caused an ozone hole over the South Pole. But why only South Pole? It is because of the presence of polar stratospheric clouds and sunlight which enhance the reaction. So the ozone in the stratosphere is known as good ozone. It protects us or the earth from the very harmful ultraviolet rays coming from the sun. But the thin layer of ozone is only left in the stratosphere now. What is the reason? One chlorine molecule released from the CFC can deplete 1 lakh ozone molecules. Because of this reason, there is a big hole over the South Pole. And why only South Pole is affected mostly? Because of the presence of polar stratospheric clouds and sunlight, which enhance the reaction between chlorine and ozone molecules. So students, I hope you have understood the topics very well. But still, if you have any doubt, you can write in the comment section. I will surely try to solve it as early as possible. Here are some review questions. Please solve it in your notebook. Thank you.